Hey guys, Victoria here and welcome back to my channel. And today, what we're looking at is the rules of indices, which I'm supposed to go over before the rules of logarithm. But I did logarithm first, but now we're back on the rules of indices and we have a total of 7 rules. So even when I was studying at maths, I was thinking like indices isn't that important or that difficult compared to log. But the thing is, when log questions are asked, it is always linked to indices, so it's a set, so you can't just know log without knowing how to do indices. And to know how to do indices, obviously you need to know the rules of indices, so that's what we're going over today. We have 7 rules in total. And the first one is AM times AN equals to AM plus N. The second rule, AM divided by AN equals to AM minus N. The third rule is AM bracket N equals to AM times N. As I'm sure you know, the bracket means multiply, so naturally this is like an unwritten rule basically. And the fourth one is that A0 equals to 1. So this means that whatever to the power of 0 is 1, like 100 to the power of 0 is 1, 3 to the power of 0 is 1. You can type it into your calculator to make sure that it's true. Number 5, 1 over mn equals to a negative n. So when you bring the power up, it will eventually become negative. And the 6th rule is am square root n equals to am 1 over n. Okay, so the same goes to if you want to change am 1 over n to am square root n. So let's say you have a number, it's just super random. Okay, 5 and 3 over 2, let's say, and you have to convert this to square root. So how do you know how to convert this to square root? So basically what I used to remember is that, okay, there are two numbers, right? We have one on top and one at the bottom. So I always think that, okay, the top one is privileged, so it gets the roof because the square root looks like the roof. So the square root is here and 5 just remains the same. And the one that is on top is like privileged and it has a better life basically, so it gets the roof. It gets to take shelter in the roof, so you write 3 here. And then the other one has to go outside the roof, so you can write 2 here. But then if it's 2, then you can just not write it because square root itself means 2. So yeah, this is the way I used to remember how to convert these to these, because I got confused on which to write here and which to write outside. And what I remember is the top one is like more privileged, so it gets the roof. Yeah, weird way, but still. Anyways, now we'll move on to the final and 7th rule of indices, which is that A over Bn equals to An over Bn. So these are the 7 rules of indices, and when it comes to answering questions about indices, it's without a doubt that you would need these 7 rules. So what I suggest you to do is to get a sticky note and write down this rule of indices. Maybe paste it around your study area where you can see it often, and whenever you come across indices question, just refer to it. I said the same thing for logarithm, but I didn't actually remember word by word. I didn't do that. But when I do indices question and I refer to this, eventually all these 7 questions become stuck to my mind, and it's like a natural thing to think of these rules. So yeah, that's all for today's video. And in the next video, we'll be looking at a question which involves both indices and logarithm. And that question will be quite difficult, so be sure to be familiar with rules of indices and logarithm first. And that's all for today's video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.